Make Dungeons Great Again.
Right. Hello, welcome back to Dungeons 3.
The Prince of Hell. Talia had reached Termite Island. The time had come to begin preparations for the attack on Dolaran and Yaina Overproud. Lakesville fell like a sandcastle under the feet of a four-year-old, and afterwards was plundered in accordance with age-old custom. Yet as satisfying as it was just a little fish in a great big ocean of good. For the hydrophobic evil had, from the start, planned to capture the city's amazing fleet, which, as opposed to the horde ships, did not sink like rocks. And so it was that Tanya's creatures were driven aboard and the sails were hoisted. As the smoking ruins of the city slowly disappeared below the horizon behind them, the ship set sail for Termite Island. Even if no one actually saw the impressive sight, as everyone was focused on the new target.
Motherfucker's playing on his phone.
The aforementioned island was the seat of the magician Yaina Overproud. Yaina was pretty and kind-hearted, and therefore, naturally, absolutely despicable.
Sounds like Panda.
If there weren't already enough reason to deal with her, she was also one of Thanos' buddies. Yaina ruled from Dolaran. Ah, Dolaran, home of arcane magic and high finance alike. Disgusting.
Disgusting.
Upon landing, the leisurely evil's army slowly made their way to the financial capital. Yet it would be a good idea to acquire additional, even more powerful allies before facing Yaina.
I like the skeleton taking pictures. Come on, neat! Click, click! Do skeletons even see? Also, I don't have skeletons yet, so why was it showing a skeleton? Maybe a skeleton was already there as a tourist? And I need to now recruit a skeleton? I can't wait to play 4, dude! I wish I could have gotten.
And the remains of the cold-blooded evil's army had reached Termite Island. Here, the egotistical magician Yaina Overproud ruled over her magical financial stronghold of Dolaran.
I'll take care of this witch in short order. We'll just build up an army and beat on everything we see, just the way we did before.
I like that idea.
It's always worked until now, whereby the question arises, what the hell kind of a strange room is that? What's it good for?
In fact, that was an excellent question. Naturally, it was a... Wait a moment. Yes, actually, it was a hellhole. A hellhole is a portal directly to hell. What do we need that for, you ask yourselves? Another excellent question. Ah, here. Because we want to summon a pit fiend, of course. The demonic and savvy evil plan to lead a pit fiend to Dolaran in order to have an ace up its sleeve in the fight against Yaina Overproud. An ingenious plan, I must say.
Okay, pit fiend sounds good. I can see him now. This guy with muscles of steel and... whatever. How do we do this?
Well, first we need a few ingredients, which we then, for the sake of simplicity, just throw into the hellhole. We need... corpse dust. However, it has to be from Termite Island, so we can't just scrape it off our zombies, but have to organize some from local graveyards. And toenails? That's simple. Oh, from a centaur. Fortunately, these primitive beings should have a few camps around here. What a coincidence. Besides that, we also need some worm slime. Ugh, just saying it makes me shudder. And spider legs. We'll probably find those kinds of creatures here in the underground. Probably a lot sooner than the tense evil would like. Oh, yes. And it also requires a couple of well-aged, but unfortunately live heroes, too. They're not likely to let themselves be thrown in there just like that, so we need a plan.
We can think about that later. The other things will be easier to get. Through fair trade? Through killing!
Itchy nose.
It's payday.
Malicious creatures are marching across Termite Island. Men, and of course women. Stop them, for the Alliance. Well, not the Alliance, but the Alliance of all good folk, and so, you know what I mean. Anyway, stop them, for the Goddess.
Whoops. Apparently the heroes weren't as stupid as they looked, and had noticed the pitter-patter and banging in the underground. As if that weren't enough, Yaina Overproud herself was there.
Excellent. That saves me a lot of time and work if I can defeat her right here.
Easy there. We really don't have the kind of budget that lets us burn a story character in a single map. Besides, it was necessary to stop the marching heroes, and then, immediately following a stay in the dungeon's own hotel, Le Prison, sacrifice them to the hellhole. Grinding sound? That's a giant worm eating its way through the underground.
Time to die!
There are enemies in your dungeon.
Yeah, probably shouldn't have.
Defend the dungeon hunt. The disgusting evil, much like the Hero Academy on Newbie Island, Termite Island was a place frequented by aspiring adventurers. When rumors of a newly opened dungeon made the rounds, many heroes came from all over the island. These would be unpleasantly surprised to encounter not a nicely balanced beginner's dungeon, but the cruel evil's complex and trap-riddled caves instead.
I need to go get evilness.
I am the queen of evil.
What's he doing? Nice. Oh, it's a giant evil turtle.
Time to take out the trash.
It's payday. Heroes are on their way to one of your islands of evilness.
What? No. That's not cool.
Eager to explore Evil's army had discovered one of the hero's camps. They immediately took care of its demolition.
Exactly! Come on! Let's tear the place apart! Another glorious victory for the Queen of Evil! I mean, for the absolute evil, of course. I mean, it's not my army. Not yet.
Where are you going?
Anyway.
No, don't go that way, idiots.
Well, I didn't vote for you. And anyways, Queen of the Damned sounds better to me.
Really? Oh, God. Terrible film. Except for the music. But of course, a bit better love story than that bit at Twilight.
I have to agree, personally. I don't care for Queen of the Damned. All right, so let's do with these
still
worms.
The Horde, I mean the evil, spread their infestation across Termite Island. Onwards, peoples of the Alliance, drive this riffraff off. Otherwise, the tourists will stay away and we'll have to close up shop.
I do what I want.
Your side. Well, later. I have something important to do in Dolaran. All the best. And for the Alliance, and so forth. Damn, that cowardly magician is escaping.
Just like I hadn't said anything. As Jaina got out of Dodge, her subordinate heroes from the nearby village did what heroes did best. Desperately head for their opponents, using brute force and violence with absolutely no finesse whatsoever. The dungeon protecting evil made ready.
Goddamn right I did. Research a brewery. Oh, oh.
There are enemies in your dungeon.
Of course they're jealous. My Super Saiyan swagger.
Thank you.
Yeah. Y'all want more fucking chickens. I get it.
Some kind of staging post would be required before any heroes could be sacrificed to the hellhole.
Yeah, I know, I got it. I gotta do the fucking...
But dead ones would be of no help to the bored evil. The solution was obvious. A prison had to be built. The always wanted to be a prison guard evil immediately began to research and build one. The first prison had been built. Now, heroes could be imprisoned when they were defeated. This was not only important for sacrificing the heroes the hellhole so desperately wanted, but also because each hero generated some evilness at the end of their stay.
Exactly. Let them stew and rot in prison, the miserable do-gooders.
Something our quick-tempered protagonist obviously desired. The very best thing, though, was the fact that any heroes that died in prison became skeletons. The necrotic evil immediately wanted to try this out, of course. Enemies have entered the dungeon.
We have more skeletons. Healing hands. Hi, you wanna go to jail for me?
The listening closely evil was informed that the demons of the hellhole might be interested in trading a handful of priestesses of the light for one of their female demons. This sounded like a very interesting trade indeed.
Really?
The first hero awoke in the prison, where his death would generate some wonderful evilness for the disgusting evil. Outstanding. Oh, yes. And some heroes also needed to be sacrificed in the hellhole. Hmm. A tough decision.
I need to expand y'all's room. Y'all's room.
Enemies
two.
Have entered the dungeon.
So many enemies. Factory farm and gobblers. Who?
Another lemming rushed over the cliff. Oh, I mean hero and hellhole, sorry.
I'm trying to get the priestess of the light thingy, because I want some free female demons.
Throw a few of these elves with the swords into the hellhole.
Why? Is that some sort of secret recipe?
Recipe? No idea. But it sounds like fun. Damn fair-skinned elves. Oh, but in the end, they are related to us. Pshh, those tree-cuddling hippies have nothing in common with us dark elves.
I'm gonna do a thing here. Cause... I think it's a really good idea. I'm gonna block that off completely so they can't steal my gold! Because if you didn't know, they will steal my gold if they're close enough to it.
The hero died in the unspeakable evil's prison. In fact, this wasn't such a bad thing. A skeleton rose from the dead hero's remains, which would henceforth serve the homicidal evil without questions or demands. The arachnomanic evil had torn off the first spider leg, just what it needed for the hellhole. It carelessly threw the rest of the spider and the remaining seven legs aside. The non-arachnophobic evil threw the first spider legs into the hellhole. Why did that please the demons? No idea. Maybe they ran out of interdental brushes.
Alright, little snots need to be able to teleport, and then too pitiful so they won't be attacked. Top of that, I need to do this. Get myself another one of you. I really can't make these guys research any faster.
Hopefully no one has arachnophobia. A spider nest has been discovered.
Take it down, boys. Sucks balls that Talia doesn't get,
The sacrifice of the spider legs was going well. The absurd evil had already accomplished half of the task. Whereby spiders are actually very useful insects, as they simply devour things such as mosquitoes and their annoying hum. How come there's no way to kill mosquitoes here, huh? That has to be much more useful. Done! All of the spider legs have been tossed into the hellhole. The spider-hating evil had mastered the assignment without even breaking a sweat.
That will be an infinite vein for me. Alright, I want to get more. Who more are you? What are we currently studying? Teleporter mat, and that one doesn't look like it's studying anything. So, what can I throw on the research?
Enemies have entered the dungeon.
Oh, I still don't have the brewery. What's wrong with me? I give it evil. Thank you. Thank you. Now I have the brewery.
Heyday. Rumor has it that the demons of the hellhole might welcome the sacrifice of a few little snots. Or maybe it's just because it's fun, too. The experimental evil immediately tried it out.
Water, Snopsy, come here! No, come here, I need to throw you in the thing. Yeah!
Nice wrist action on that throw. Enemies have entered the dungeon.
That do anything?
Listening closely, Evil was informed that the demons of the hellhole might be interested in trading a handful of priestesses of the light for one of their female demons. This sounded like a very interesting trade indeed.
Yeah, I've already thrown in a couple novices.
The demon appeasing Evil had sacrificed a hero.
Is that not what they want? Well, I'm gonna throw a beer room down. It's the what are the priests of the light? I'm guessing it's the novices, but like, how many would I need to sacrifice? You know?
Merciless Evil's armies destroyed the Hobbit camp with joyful efficiency. These hobbits wouldn't be running off throwing any rings into any lava in any mountains anymore. Whoops! The first centaur had lost one of its toenails. But it was exactly what the absolutely no regrets whatsoever evil needed for the hellhole.
What's this way?
The exploratory evil had discovered a sweet little graveyard. Would it be able to find some of the corpse dust if needed here? As a really, really broad hint, the savvy narrator pointed out to the perplexed evil that the graves in the graveyard might just need a hearty smack or nudge to release the valuable corpse dust.
Oh, there's a book. Oh, there it is. Armor bonus.
I will destroy this land.
Payday.
This hero camp has been destroyed. Excellent work. So now let's do it again.
All the poor souls who have to die because of my failure and my lack of willpower. It's so sad.
Ha ha ha! Plunder, burn, kill.
The first centaur toenails disappeared. Da-da-da. A short neigh could be heard. I don't really want to know what the demons do with those. The first corpse dust was sacrificed to the hellhole. An excellent start for the sacrifice offering.
I thought they had two novices with them.
My secret and mystical counselors, who only I can see, tell me that the demons would love to see some skilled elven archers thrown into the hellhole. Apparently, they need someone to hunt giant mosquitoes.
Counselors only you can see? My goodness, as if your split personality wasn't annoying enough.
I can't really argue with you there. I too wish that Sister Goody Two Shoes would finally go and bother someone else.
Doors. I just realized what I did here. Excuse me.
There are enemies in your dungeon. Well, hello, you beautiful demon. Oh, the demons of the hellhole gave the still-to-be-embalmed evil some of their succubi as thanks for the sacrifice.
Nice. I don't know what they do, but I got some.
payday.
Noodles.
There are enemies in your dungeon. The prepared to make a sacrifice evil threw another hero into the hellhole. Another lemming rushed over the cliff. Oh, I mean hero and hellhole, sorry.
Oh, need more room. Okay.
There are enemies in your dungeon.
Kind of curious if she's actually like
the demons beyond the hellhole.
Oh,
gathered about the wicked evil's sacrifice and threw a few miserable imps through the portal in thanks. Cute.
Oh, that might be because I finished it off. That sucks. Okay.
Snod just disappeared into the hellhole. The generous evil had disposed of a significant number of little snots in the hellhole. While the demon princes didn't acknowledge the sacrifice, it did lead to an unusual increase in the remaining little snots' willingness to work, as they became obviously more than willing to make themselves indispensable.
Ha! Excellent motivational work.
That's great.
While the sacrifice, of course, pleased the pit fiends beyond the hellhole, it didn't seem to induce them to send anything in trade. Obviously, they only wanted to make each trade once, cheapskates. The prepared to make a sacrifice evil threw another hero into the hellhole. Another lemming rushed over the cliff. Oh, I mean hero and hellhole, sorry.
No, I think you're right. They're lemmings. I mean, if they decided to come into my dungeon, they gotta be stupid.
There are enemies in your dungeon.
I might have a couple too many people.
Enemies have entered the dungeon. The hero disappeared into the hellhole with a long, drawn-out and an almost reckless disregard for gravity. The demon appeasing evil had sacrificed a hero.
Bad thing is my army can literally only get stronger. I can still upgrade. Let me see here. Where are you? Yeah, you're alive now. Cool.
It's payday.
Alright, I think that I'm just gonna sit in here and continue to, just upgrade my shit. Get some healing beer going. What we got in here? Go in the pit.
The demon appeasing evil had sacrificed a hero.
Even more beer to store. Yeah, let's go, man. You just killed a demon through a wall, you fucking cheater.
Heroes want to attack one of your islands of evilness.
Sorry guys, no rest for the wicked.
What's up?
There's a book. Wage reduction. Nope. You. Yeah.
Thanos must die.
Bed. Lay down.
Healing beer. Been waiting for that one. Gobblers are fucking insane. What?
How many do you have?
100. They're just so loud.
You don't have to have them right now. Play me. Wait.
I wish I could turn gold into, you know, evilness. But I can't. Look at all that beer.
Payday.
They're coming at my bait, at my place. They're trying to attack me, you guys. I'm scared. There's so much of this dungeon I haven't explored this time.
There are enemies in your dungeon.
Oh no, guys, there's enemies in my dungeon. What am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? I'm scared. Like, freaking out, man. Just kidding. I'm making like a nice big guard room here. Damn well better making that much noise. Exciting guard duty. 21. not big enough. Oh my lord, it's still not big enough. I have 10,000 gold. Everyone's on guard duty now. Everyone's a guard. That's stupid. I love it. And human conditions 3. I need Unnerring Nagas. That's something I need to. And I need loud screamers as well.
Enemies have entered the dungeon.
But this way they'll all always be there, you know?
There are enemies in your dungeon.
Well, there was. Sure, there were enemies in my dungeon at one point, but there ain't no more.
It's payday. A couple of worms are worming through your dungeon. Crush the worms.
This is a method I like to call script. I'm just mining in script. And if something interesting pops up, I should be able to see it.
countless spiders pouring out of a room that was accidentally unearthed. Disgusting.
Ouch! Ouch!
See, like this, right here? Somewhere? Right there? There's a gold vein. Plus all this mana here. This is just a straight up, like, gold vein room. Loud screamers, unnerving nagas. I think I've got everything I want, really. To get one more Gobblebot and one more Naga, so I'm actually gonna eat this guy into the...
A couple of worms are worming through your dungeon. Crush the worms. Enemies have entered the dungeon.
A bit of gold there. Another bit of gold there. Put your thing there.
It's payday.
That's now maxed out.
Enemies have entered the dungeon.
Now I can just upgrade my unit and chill. I don't need to, but it's fun.
The hellhole rewarded the sacrifice of a live hero with a respectable burp.
All right, I can't be upset about that one. That was great. Yeah, see, and there's a little bit left here. What's in that right there? What's with that? You know. Right here, there's a little bit of gold. Just dig into the edge, make sure, you know. Got everything. There ain't no other, you know, infinite gold, infinite vein anywhere. Digging a bit there because we can. And just clean it up, make sure we got everything all hooked up and looted properly, you know. Like to have everything nice and looted. Look at that. See, there's mana over here. That'll be good for healing my demons when we're out, because there ain't nobody in here making mana. I think my mana is actually kind of cool. Yeah. Yeah, pretty damn cool. Alright, I'll be right back. I'm gonna let this run, and I'm just gonna let you guys watch this. I'll be right back, and see you guys in a minute.
Enemies have entered the dungeon.
We didn't lose nobody. That's good. All right. Let's see here.
I am damn, even dude. Stronger.
She takes up a lot, but she's really powerful too. So.
Put me on the enemy.
It's payday.
What do you want me to do?
Why are they splitting up? What the fuck is wrong with them?
hero disappeared into the hellhole with a long, drawn-out and an almost reckless disregard for gravity.
Yeah, the demons, they actually come out if you're out here. It's pretty cool.
Who do you want dead?
Who the fuck is dead back here? A zombie. Of course a zombie's dead.
The far-sighted evil had discovered a modest little centaur camp. Like any good, nature-loving being, the horrible evil immediately wanted to convert this area into a nature reserve. Of course, that meant that everything that was in the way had to go. Oh, those poor centaurs. Unfortunately, they had to die for the good of the greater evil. It was done. The last unicorn, I mean the last centaur, had lost its toenail, which the eager evil quickly sacrificed to the hellhole. As it did so, it realized that every centaur actually had four of the stupid things. Naturally, that would have made the job just a bit easier. But hey, outstanding intelligence was never an employment criterion for evil arch-villains. Either way, the goal had been achieved.
I feel attacked. He called me stupid.
The prepared to make a sacrifice evil threw another hero into the hellhole. The fabulous evil's armies had reached the city. Yaina, however, was long gone.
Then I suppose I'll just have to take it out on the inhabitants. Forward! Haven't you plunged enough cities into ruins? Is that a trick question? I'll admit, I could have saved myself the question. You monster! Thanks!
Oh, I have to go through the city to get there? Oh, okay.
Sadly, one of the hero's mighty champions lived in the city. Ronin, whose cliché-soaked name we stole one-to-one from another universe, had retired here and was anything but pleased to see evil creatures. However, whoever put that sanctimonious do-gooder's lights out permanently was sure to be richly rewarded.
Reward or not, it'll be fun. Come on, fight!
The great champion Ronin hit the floor. The radiant with happiness evil was extremely pleased. At the same time, this anti-heroic act was generously rewarded.
Another city destroyed. You're so evil and cruel. Thanks, that's really nice of you. I despise you. Careful now. Hate leads to the dark side.
The strategically brilliant evil had eliminated all the dangers and made the dungeon a fairly safe place. Summoning the Pit Fiend should now be child's play.
Another graveyard. Excellent.
No, get.
We should be able to find the rest of the corpse dust. Get a move on, people! Loot those graves!
My toenails are curling. Looting graves? How repulsive!
Yeah, yeah. Go share your moral outrage with someone who cares.
Go away.
Enemies have entered the dungeon.
Yeah, level 10. Like I said, at level 10, they have 50 and 20 life energy and damage percentage. There's a banshee that's healing, two banshees that are healing, and that's it. Two banshees need to heal. Which I can do that, and she's healed, and that one, the skeletal archer. He just stole all the barrels of beer.
payday. Enemies have entered the dungeon.
I wasn't paying attention. I just want to see just how many gobblers I can actually get. Jesus Christ. 435 gobblers. It's going to be this is going to be stupid. Stop at 455. Why not just keep going? Fuck it. Got nothing else to do with all this room.
There are enemies in your dungeon.
GOBBLERS.
It's payday.
Part of me believes that just isn't enough. Where are these guys carrying mana from? Everywhere? I must have all of it. I'll hear some. I'm gonna fill this whole thing up with mana. Oi! Build the wall! I know, I could easily finish the mission, but I'm having fun. Piece there, why? Okay, I'm gonna take down this whole wall and... Yeah, okay, that's weird. Okay, it's not connected to the other side. I get it. Okay. Because that... I took a screenshot. That's my thumbnail. That's the thumbnail for the stream. I broke the game with gobblers.
It's payday.
This is absolutely retarded, and I love it. Where's my tinker machine? I don't even know. Jesus Christ. It just gets worse. Oh, wait. Percent of 50. Whoops.
There are enemies in your dungeon.
Jesus Lord. Look at my goblins going up. Hey, you want to see something funny? Da na na.
Oh my god.
And 1,140. I could have a total of 1,165.
Fiends of the hellhole were evidently grateful for the sacrifice of some gobbling fowl and gave the ripping them off so badly evil something in exchange for them. Huh. Who would have thought that those stupid creatures were good for more than just a tasty snack?
Wow, I sacrificed chickens and the hellhole gave me an experience book. That's insane. That's hilarious. I wonder if I could do the same with gold. Oh, let's find out. Guess not. Well, looks like it's time for more Gobbler Farm. I'm an absolute madman. This is dumb. But I'm gonna do it.
There are enemies in your dungeon.
I don't even have 20 FPS right here anymore. I got 5. This will be the end of it right here. I won't go any farther than that. How many we can hold in total when this is all done? Well, that's going. I'm going to take this area. Make it a beer storage area.
It's payday.
We're gonna have a huge party once I complete this level. Oh, one more level. So this stores 657 barrels of beer.
Enemies have entered the dungeon.
Ooh, excuse me. Jesus Christ. 2,805. I want to go farther. I so badly want to try and go through the entire dungeon. Look at all that. That's ridiculous. That shouldn't be allowed. You know you've done good when you when your frames drop below fucking 20 when you're looking at it. This is stupid. I love it.
The graveyard's ludicrous guards had been retired. Good thing for the gravedigger, who didn't have to go far this time.
Oh my god. It's so laggy. It's so stuttery. It's beautiful.
Thank you.
Oh my god.
Heyday.
The only thing, the only regret I have is that gobblers can't attack.
There are enemies in your dungeon.
Look at these guys.
The possessive evil wanted to gather other ingredients, but found that it was already carrying some. More corpse dust was sacrificed as the rulers of hell rejoiced. The heavily armored metal glove wearing evil rubbed its hands in blissful anticipation of unleashing a prince of hell upon the overworld, which proved quite painful due to the many spikes. It was done. All of the required corpse dust. Finally, it was done. The last ingredient had been thrown into the hellhole.
I had to stop.
The victorious evil patted itself on the back in triumph. The hellhole began to bubble and make fart noises. Something in the middle whirled wildly, while it slowly grew. The sound that caused it could be seen as a demonic litany, but upon listening closer, one recognized a joyful whee! It was the Pit Fiend, who now emerged from the whirlpool with a wild laugh. Laugh. Oh, do I do that? Okay.
Prince of Darkness, obey my orders, and of course those of the absolute evil. You mighty pit fiend, cruelest of the cruel.
His name is Crowley.
Oh god, it's Crowley.
It says here in the script the pit fiend's name is Crowley. Not that it's important since he doesn't speak, but I just wanted to mention it.
All right, Crowley. You, Crowley, will help us defeat Yaina Overproud. We will transform this world into an image of hell.
Daughter, try.
Hey, get out of my dungeon!
Your evilness. I still haven't given up on you. Fight it! Use all your willpower.
Oh, Father, I'm still here. I'm trying. Well, now and then, at least. But my evil self won't let me talk about it. It refuses to hear my arguments and...
It doesn't care what you say. How often do I have to tell you?
The pit fiend Crowley listened to Talia's inner quarrel and grumbled at Thanos' words. Non-residents of hell were so annoying. Thanos disappeared after the evil Talia's rant and tirade of insults. She then turned to Crowley.
Come, pit fiend. I mean Crowley. Let's get that accursed magician. Yaina Overproud, your days are numbered.
Alright, let's see. Mana collected, heroes converted, toolboxes, doors built, traps built, creature deaths, creature meter trap, damage dealt. Yeah, what... Barrels of build, the spear, yep, mana dug up, yep, toolboxes, creatures fired, beer drank. Gobblers eaten! Gobblers eaten, 814. Wait, you can strike gobblers but with the hand of terror? Oh. You could heal prisoner damage. Well,
the storming of Dalaran.
That's gonna do it for me today. A little bit shorter one today, but I want to relax. I was having fun, but I want to relax, like, in my chair, lean back, chill. Thank you guys for being here. I hope you enjoyed that insanity. As always, thanks for watching. Peace out.